In this video, we will discuss about gap arthroplasty. This is first given by the Abbe as a one of the treatment options for TMJ ankylosis. There are three mainstay treatment options for TMJ ankylosis. The first one is condylectomy, second one is gap arthroplasty, and third one is interpositional arthroplasty. Coming to the gap arthroplasty, it is nothing but creation of a gap in between the glenoid fossa and the remaining ramus stem after the excision of the ankyloidic mass. That is the name derived from that. This is gap arthroplasty. Then coming to the objectives. The objectives of not only gap arthroplasty but other two treatment options also, that is treatment of any TMJ ankylosis, will aim to restore the jaw function, to restore the joint function or mandibular function, and to restore the mouth opening, and to treat the facial asymmetries caused due to the TMJ ankylosis, and to promote the normal child growth, that is normal temporomandibular joint growth in the case of children who are in the growth period. Okay, so these are the four main treatment objectives of gap arthroplasty. One, restoration of jaw function, restoration of the mandibular function, otherwise restoration of the mouth opening, okay, and treatment of any facial asymmetries, any treatment of facial asymmetries. Then coming to the indications, this gap arthroplasty is mainly indicated for true ankylosis of the temporomandibular joint, that is ankylosis due to the intra-articular causes. There must be a bony fusion between the glenoid fossa and the condylar stem. So we are going to remove that bony mass. Then coming to the surgical technique, the first thing we have to discuss about the surgical approaches. There are many surgical approaches by which we can access to the temporomandibular joint, but the basic one is the preauricular approach. There are other approaches, submandibular approach, postramal approach, post-auricular approach, okay. So there are so many, endoral approach. We'll make a separate video on the TMJ surgical access, but the preauricular is the basic one. So in this video we are going to describe the gap arthroplasty procedure through preauricular approach. Okay, the first step is to take the preauricular incision. Take an incision, skin incision, at the junction between the helix of the ear and the skin of the fascia. Okay, in this diagram, this is the helix of the ear complete, and then this is the zygomatic arch, and this is the condyle and the coronoid process. These are underlying structures. Okay, so we are going to take the skin incision at the junction of helix and the facial skin. That is this one. This red line describes you the skin incision. After you take the incision, you dissect through the skin and subcutaneous tissue down to the temporoparietal fascia or temporalis fascia. Temporalis fascia contains one superficial layer and deep layer. Okay, in this diagram we have dissected down to the temporalis fascia. Okay, so this is the complete temporalis fascia, this whitish layer completely temporalis fascia, and these red lines demarcates you the flap margins. So the middle red line, this red line is the incision through the temporalis fascia, superficial layer of the temporalis fascia. After incising that, again you carry out the dissection through the superficial layer of the temporalis fascia, and over the zygoma, over the zygomatic arch, you can incise the periosteum also. Okay, above the zygomatic arch, your dissection is up to the level of the superficial layer of temporalis fascia. At the zygomatic arch, you will directly incise the periosteum also to expose the zygomatic arch. And below the zygomatic arch, you are going to dissect till the TMJ capsule is seen. So you can see in this diagram, this is the middle part. You can see that middle part you can assume it as a zygomatic arch. Above that is the fat after dissecting the superficial layer of temporalis fascia, and below this zygomatic arch, these white lines are the TMJ capsule. So we are going to make an incision in the TMJ capsule. This black lines denotes the TMJ incision in the TMJ capsule. This is the lateral aspect of the view. The same thing we are doing here. It is the lateral aspect. Okay. So in this is the zygomatic arch. This is the zygomatic arch, and below this is the mandibular condyle. Okay. So these black lines denote the TMJ capsule. This TMJ capsule connects down to the mandibular condylar neck, and it connects with the articular disc. This intervening red color structure is the articular disc, and inferiorly it is attached to the mandibular condylar neck, and superiorly it is attached to the glenoid fossa. That is nothing but temporal aspect of the glenoid fossa. Okay, so in this diagram, this incision in the TMJ capsule, you can see here like this. It should be continuously like this, but we have incised TMJ capsule here. Okay, so this is the incision in the TMJ capsule. Once you incise the TMJ capsule and you dissect down to the mandibular bony mass. So in this diagram, that is after dissection and incision of TMJ capsule, you can see the bony mass. You can see the bony anatomy here. This is the coronoid process, and the condylar process is completely within the bony mass, and this is the zygomatic arch, and this is the glenoid fossa. Complete this block marking is the bony mass, you can see in the ankylosis case. Okay, so after making and after knowing this bony anatomy, you are going to do two horizontal osteotomies within the bone to remove the bony chunk. The one superior horizontal osteotomy and inferior horizontal osteotomy. This is the main gap arthroplasty procedure, that is removal of the bony chunk. You must understand here. There are two horizontal osteotomies. One is towards the or near to the glenoid fossa, and the inferior one is the almost at the condylar neck or below the complete bony ankylotic mass. Okay, with these two horizontal cuts, you are going to remove this complete bony chunk. Okay, so when you are doing superior horizontal osteotomy, you must be cautious not to perforate within the glenoid fossa. If the bony anatomy is completely understood, and you must read this bony anatomy in your radiographs, that is CT scan, like before you are planning the procedure. Okay, there must not be any perforation into the middle cranial fossa, and inferiorly there must be a gap of 1 to 1.5 centimeter. This is very much important point in this topic. You can be asked in a Viva or PG question, that is what is the gap, minimum gap you are going to create, that is 1 to 1.5 centimeters, otherwise 10 to 15 mm. Okay, so with these two osteotomies, we are going to remove this bony chunk. You can shape the glenoid fossa with the bony burrs, with the bone cutting burrs, after you remove completely this bony chunk. Okay, after removal of the bony chunk, then this neck, now you can see this is the glenoid fossa, and this is the remaining condylar stump, and this is the coronoid process. So we have made a gap between glenoid fossa and the remaining condylar stump with at least 1 to 1.5 centimeter. Okay, after that you check for mouth opening. If it is more than 35 mm, there is no need to do the coronoidectomy. If it is not more than 35 mm, then do the coronoidectomy, ipsilateral coronoidectomy. If required, do other side coronoidectomy also. From this step, you have to follow the Kaban's protocol. Accordingly, you have to go Kaban's protocol. Okay, so this is basically gap arthroplasty. Interpositional arthroplasty, the procedure is almost completely same till this step. Okay, after this, what you are going to do in interpositional arthroplasty is you are going to take temporalis muscle from the temporal aspect of the temporal fossa, and we are going to turn it down, and we are going to keep interposing between the glenoid fossa and the remaining root stump, remaining condylar ramus stump. Okay, so this is generally about gap arthroplasty and interpositional arthroplasty. After that, after confirming the sufficient gap between these two, and the most important point here is to remove completely bony mass. Remove the bony mass completely, otherwise there is high chances of re-ankylosis, especially on the medial aspect. When you are removing the bone, you must plan it before how much depth you have to go, like that. And there are many important structures here. You must take care about those things, like maxillary artery, otherwise superficial temporal artery, facial nerve. You must take care about those vital structures not to injure when you are removing the bony stump. After removing the bony stump and after confirming the mouth opening, then you are going to close the incision site. Closure must be done in layers. That means first you have to close the TMJ capsule. After that you have to close the temporalis fascia. After that, skin closure. So there must be three layer closure. This is the step by step gap arthroplasty procedure. Then coming to the advantages. Gap arthroplasty is the simpler and quicker technique when compared to the interpositional arthroplasty, because we are not going to take the temporalis fascia or temporalis muscle and turn it down and put it in between them, because it takes skillful action and time. So it is simpler and quickest technique when compared to the interpositional arthroplasty. When coming to the disadvantages, the most common disadvantage is chances of re-ankylosis, because we are not interposing anything in between this. That is the main disadvantages. Re-ankylosis chances are high after gap arthroplasty, especially if you are not going to create this amount of gap, 1 to 1.5 centimeter. Then coming to the complications. The main complications when you are doing the upper horizontal osteotomy is creation of perforation into the middle cranial fossa. That is main thing you have to understand, not to perforate into the middle cranial fossa. Okay, and there are some other complications also. Anterior open bite after the procedure. Okay, otherwise decreased ramus length or decreased ramus vertical length after the amount of bony removal. Okay, these are the some of the complications of the gap arthroplasty. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel, and if you have any doubt, mention in the comment box.